talking about Team Today, which is Cashless Society. So first, I will introduce myself. My name is Nagora. I will be speaker 1.
Hi everyone, my name is Farhana Natasha as a speaker 2 and the timekeeper for today.
Hi, my name is Izana Suha and as speaker 3.
Hello, hi, greetings and good day. Good to know you all. I'm Logo, who will be speaker 4 for today's discussion.
Hi. So, I'll be doing the introduction for Cashless Society. So, what is Cashless Society? So, it's just a financial system of the country that uses electronic or digital devices to send money, send transactions and pay bills using digitally and not using physical cash. So physical cash is almost mostly or maybe even entirely absent from the country's economy. So to pay from our transactions and pay our bills, there's no physical cash at all. So these transactions are usually paid with debit cards, credit cards, QR codes, mobile payments and the likes. So for me personally, I think it's a good idea to become a cashless society. Because I do think that keeping track of your transactions would be very efficient, would be very precise, because every single time you do an online transaction, your online bank application would present to you what did you pay, how much did you did the transaction. And this can range from several months in the past, maybe until the present. So it's very easy to keep track of your purchases. So I think it is very efficient. So what about you?
That's right, but don't you think that it will make us do the unlimited spending and do the reckless spending? Yeah, because also I agree that since the implementation of COVID-19, when all transactions must be contactless, we have begun using cashless system. And that is really dangerous because it encourages us to spend money limitlessly before our purchases. Our finances might be spent mindlessly, like water. When we have cash, okay, we will be more conservative with the money we have. For instance, when we want to make purchases, we will be more calculating according to the capacity of the actual wallet. And this is extremely different from when we have money in our account that we don't see the actual amount. So for me, cash is crucial at that time because certain businesses do not provide any a QR display or any type of transaction that enables the purchases. And so you must carry cash on you or at all time as a backup is in case of emergencies.
So for me, I think personally, I see where you're coming from. I understand your points, but I have to disagree. I have to disagree that you must carry physical cash on you at all times in your wallet, because I think even in the most dire situations, I think you can just ask the person who you need to send money to, their bank account or their other types of online payment, and you can just send money that way. So for me, I have to disagree with your point. So does anyone else have their thoughts or opinions?
Nazura, your point is good also, but cashless society will expose our personal information to a possible data breach. Not only that, cybercrime will get our personal information when money is involved. Never too far behind, cyber criminals move operator with cunning ploys like hacking or phishing, which is not safe, Nazura. This scammer can come in all space, all shape, all size, and change all this time. As our money become increasingly digital, their window of opportunity widens. I would like to highlight again, a cashless society increases the risk of fraud as transactions happen digitally without physical evidence. Hackers can access digital payment system and steal our money. while identity theft and phishing scams also happen frequently. Logaf, what's your point? Nazura agreeing on our topic, while Farhana and myself disagreeing. What's about you?
Okay, alright, thank you Liz for the question. So I think on the last point that you've stated about scammers, especially on stealing money while our identity is being published to the scammers, where it is possible for the scammers to have our unauthorized transaction without permission, is something that is happening right now at the world, where a lot of Malaysians actually right now, I've heard, and also I have experienced myself on unauthorized transaction where my information have been taken, and there have been transactions happening about for 2 months, but I get the notification after 2 months on the data that my money has been cut off from my bank. So this is currently happening, and it is a bit risky. But at the same time, I think I would like to highlight back here that the purpose of today's discussion is to determine whether cashless payment is more efficient and safer compared to the use of cash. But I think at the end of this discussion, we hope to come to an agreement, right, everybody, on the issue, particularly we are agreeing or disagreeing. But it cannot be denied that there is a wide variety of benefit to be gained by a society to form a cashless system, as mentioned by Nazuha just now. In a society where time is as important as money, going cashless can be a big help, since the main benefit that society can get from a cashless system is much more convenience. But more than that, I would like to highlight that instead of having a hard time to finding the exact amount of coins or cash in one's pocket to pay for a cup of tea, a person can just insert a piece of plastic card, which is our bank card, through the slot. Instantly, we can pay the exact amount that we would like to purchase and deduct it accurately, the amount that we need to pay. So I think I would like to agree with Nazuha on this topic. And what about you, Farhana? What do you would like to say about this?
However, I still disagree with the cashless society should be conducted just because it requires us to count cash at the time, and because when our card is stolen or price fraud happen without our knowledge, the PayWave system, which is on every card, is the most harmful because it can happen automatically and it just takes a few seconds without we knowing, and at least takes a few seconds, and it just occurs that quickly. At least if we have having cash, at least it will give us more time to think and to think steadily and wisely. Don't just step and like that.
I think I agree with Farhana points, because sometimes we have to pay with at cashier. The cashier will take advantage from you to take extra money without you knowing. This situation happened to me when I want to pay and get the receipt. I see the total amount different with the initial price. The price got more prices. So yeah.
So which means you guys still disagree on this point. What about Nasua? Can you give a point to agree on our topic?
Okay. So I do agree that digital transactions can be quite harmful, because there is accidents, just like you said. Because I've also experienced it before. I've had someone who somehow got a hold of my debit card information, so my entire number, they had my entire debit card number and tried to make a transaction of 500 ringgit to some establishment or maybe even their own bank account. So it's one of the two. So they tried to do that transaction, but unfortunately for them and fortunately for me, I didn't have 500 ringgit in my bank. I'm just a student. Very thankful. So, and then immediately when that transaction tried to proceed, I got a text message from the bank itself, so the official SMS from the bank. So they said, hey, this seems to be suspicious activity, because they know that I'm a student, I don't have stable financial money, so it can be quite suspicious to suddenly have 500 ringgit out of my bank account, even though I don't have that much money in my bank. So they sent a text message. Seems suspicious, and you're usually not in this area, so that's my warning to me. So that's their warning to me. So I had to call my bank, cancel my debit card, and then I have to go to the bank to issue a new debit card. So that means I have to take out more money to issue a new debit card. Mm-hmm. So I do agree that it can be very tedious and very harmful, mm-hmm. and maybe wasteful of money. But I still heavily agree on my point, because they have their own security firewall, their own security
support that is being held even to them, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. So they gave each other one. Yes. So I think that was professional of them.
Okay.
They helped me to not lose money. So that's their way of stopping fraud.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my point.
So, which means, what we'd like to conclude, that we have our point that we are agreeing and disagreeing on the same time, but on a scale, as we can see, that all of us can agree that going cashless is more convenient at the world where we would like to move on forward as fast and also make our things easier and make a quick move. I think being cashless is much more convenient and also better, as somehow you guys also agreed on that. So what do you guys think? Would you like to continue to agree on this topic so I can conclude?
So for me, I'm mm-hmm. still on my side that I heavily agree that we should become a cashless country. It would be more efficient for us, it would be more safer for us, because I do believe it would help in our society at large. So I think in the future, it will be beneficial for us. That's still my point. What about yours?
For me, I still disagree, because I don't want cashless society should be conducted immediately in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because there are too many consequences
yeah.
from it. Like, it's harmful, dangerous, and
fraud.
Yeah, it's not.
It might be too soon to
yes.
jumpstart into a new way.
And we need cash as a backup too.
I understand.
Yeah.
What about this?
Are you disagree or agree?
I disagree, because I stick with my point, because give me impact because of the skill.
Yes.
So,
yeah.
I think it is very hard to convince our discussion that we agree or disagree, because there are very strong pros and cons in this discussion. So with that, I think we would like to stick with our discussion to be hanging, because it depends on the particular individual to decide. It is beneficial for them to use cashless or for them to use with cash.
Right.
So it depends on each individual to decide whether being or using cash is better or not better, because it all makes sense to use card for business things to help speed up the process and to get shorter queues. At the same time, it is also risky. So we already end our discussion. So I hope that we will have more discussion after this, and I hope everybody enjoyed learning something new from today's discussion. And thank you guys for joining, and thank you to everyone.
Can I add my own point?
Oh yes, sure. You can conclude our discussion also.
So I know I said I very strongly agree on being a cashless society, but I think you both have opened up my eyes too, that hey, there's not just pros of being cashless, there's cons too, there's some dangers. So, and then if I'm just straight up unlucky, like my fraud, like my transaction fraud, I think that we should be mindful of the ones who don't want to become a cashless society. So that's my own, that's my last one. Thank you everyone.
So with that, we can conclude. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone.
That's our conclusion. That's all. Bye.